knew it was you.
You? Picard, if you had half the sense you pretend to have, you would get her off your ship immediately. And if you'd like, I'd be more than pleased to expedite her departure.
You know him?
We have had some dealings.
Those dealings were 2 centuries ago. This creature is not what she appears to be. She's an imp. And where she goes, trouble always follows.
You're speaking of yourself, Q, not Guinan.
Guinan? Is that your name now?
Guinan is not the issue here. You are. We had an agreement that you would stop meddling with us.
And so I have.
What do you want, Q? You state your business. Get on with it.
I agree, Captain. Enough about this creature. She's diverting us from the purpose of my being here.
Which is?
Oh, the redoubtable Commander Riker. And Microbrain. Growl for me. Let me know you still care.
Worf.
My purpose is to join you.
To join us as what?
As a member of the crew, willing and able, ready to serve. This ship is already home for the indigent, the unwanted, the unworthy. Why not for a homeless entity?
Homeless?
Yes.
The other members of the Q continuum kicked you out.
Not all the Q are alike. Some are almost respectable.
Ready and willing. Able to serve. What would you do? Would you start as an ordinary crewman? What task is too menial for an entity?
Sir, do you mock me?
Not at all. That's the last thing I would do. You, by definition, are part of our charter. Our mission is to seek out new and different life forms, and you certainly qualify as one of the most unique I've ever encountered.
To learn about you is frankly provocative. But you're next of kin to chaos.
Captain, at least allow me to present my argument.
Worf.
After our last encounter, I was asked to leave the Q Continuum. Since then, I've been wandering vaguely. Bored, really. My existence without purpose. Then I remembered all the good times I had with you.
The good times? The first time we met you, you put us on trial for the crimes of humanity.
Oh, which you were exonerated.
The next time we saw you, you asked me to join the Q Continuum.
A big mistake that you didn't accept my offer. More and more I realized that here is where I want to be. Think of the advantages. Now, I neither expect nor require any special treatment. And if necessary, although I can't imagine why, I will renounce my powers and become as weak and as incompetent as all of you.
No.
No? Oh, Captain, in fairness, let me try. I deserve at least that much.
In fairness? You disrupt this ship? You kidnap the captain?
I add a little excitement, a little spice to your lives, and all you do is complain. Where's your adventurous spirit, your imagination? Think, Picard, think. Think of the possibilities.
Simply speaking, we don't trust you.
Oh. Well, you may not trust me, but you do need me. You're not prepared for what awaits you.
How can we be prepared for that which we do not know? But I do know that we are ready to encounter it.
Really?
Yes, absolutely. That's why we're out here.
Oh, the arrogance. They don't have a clue as to what's out here.
But they will learn. Adapt. That is their greatest advantage.
They're moving faster than expected, further than they should.
By whose calculations?
You judge yourselves against the pitiful adversaries you've encountered so far. The Romulans, the Klingons. They're nothing compared to what's waiting. Picard, you are about to move into areas of the galaxy containing wonders more incredible than you can possibly imagine, and terrors to freeze your soul. I offer myself as guide, only to be rejected out of hand.
We'll just have to do the best we can without you.
What justifies that smugness?
Not smugness, not arrogance. But we're resolute, we're determined. And your help is not required.
We'll just have to see how ready you are.
Kill!